Let me ride in your big Cadillac.
I'm here on our last day of shooting on the film Blaze, and one of the most challenging things about making a movie about world-class musicians is that if the movie doesn't have world-class music, then its whole heart is fake and the whole center of the movie will fall apart and it won't be worth watching at all. So one of the first things that we all gave thought to is how could we achieve a level of authenticity in the music that would be superlative and worth somebody's time. And so we really set out to do that, and one of the easiest things for me to do in the world is to say thank you to PreSonus, because they made it possible for us. They started us out, they gave us everything we needed, we got to do all our pre-records there. When we needed backup singers, we had backup singers. We needed a bass player, we had a bass player. When we needed people to record in the middle of the night, they were there for us. And I have to say that it put our whole team off on the right foot and gave us set a bar for the level of quality that we were aspiring for. And I'll forever be grateful to PreSonus for that. Well, I love working here on this project with these people. You know, you spend your life trying to make something worth watching. You know, I've spent my life trying to do that. Sometimes you do and sometimes you don't, but very rarely do you have a team of people that are as much fun to be around as we've had, and a subject matter that's more interesting and more dear to people's hearts. I think that's part of the... There's something. Every biopic about a musician you've ever seen, it's about a famous musician, as if the point of... as if their story weren't worth telling if they didn't make it big. And there's been something kind of beautiful and galvanizing, I think, for the whole crew about celebrating somebody who we all believe in, but that maybe others aren't familiar with. It feels purposeful because of that. You know, for me, it's been a long, winding road. When I was a little kid, my dad was a huge Willie Nelson fan, right? My first album was Redheaded Stranger, and I started getting into outlaw country music. And just my whole life, Willie and Waylon and Chris and Merle and Johnny Cash. And then slowly, if you dive down that hole long enough, you start to come up with Townes Van Zandt. And you start to kind of find some of the more, the people who had the beating heart of it that maybe weren't as successful. And I didn't know Blaze for a while, but as I started sharing Towns with friends, remember somebody once said to me, "Well, you know Blaze Foley, don't you?" I was like, "I don't know. He's the guy Townes Van Zandt was pretending to be, and Willie's pretending to be Towns." You know what I mean? So says, this is the straight stuff. You know, this is the pure whiskey, so to speak. And so then I started listening to it. And then one day I heard Ben Dickey play a Blaze Foley song. And then I introduced Ben to Jake Seal, and now we're wrapping the movie.